Auntie Okpe is back, and of course, with trending stories around the world.
Good morning, Leila. How are you? I missed you.
So we're doing high five, Doctor.
No handshake, please. We can't handshake. You just came back from France.
So our handshake is suspended for how long now?
14 days.
I mean, I would feel like it would.
Take further notice. LOG.
We are in England now. So why don't we just do the foot thing now?
Yeah, you can do the foot thing. I missed you, Dr. Basil. I wish I could see that.
Well, good morning to you, viewers. We begin What's Trending Today in Ireland. And guess who's been shaking people? The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge.
Oh, wow.
Right. Britain's Prince William has joked about unwittingly spreading the new coronavirus. The Duke of Cambridge made the comment on the first evening of his three-day visit to Ireland while meeting emergency workers at a reception in Dublin hosted by Britain's ambassador to Ireland. Talking to emergency workers, the prince said, "I bet everyone's like, I've got coronavirus." And you're like, "No, you've got just a cough." The prince also questioned whether media coverage of the infection was excessive. He said, in quote, "It does seem quite dramatic about the coronavirus at the moment. Is it being a little hyped up, do you think, by the media?" End quote. In another video clip from the event, Prince William was heard saying, "By the way, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are spreading coronavirus. Sorry, we're keeping an eye on that. So do tell us if we need to stop." The royal couple shook hands with dozens of people on the first day of their tour. I mean, I think he's put some little light on the coronavirus thing, but,
You know, this is a good thing about the world. Even in the midst of obvious tragedy, people try to, create jokes around it. And you must have seen quite a lot, on social media. But, of course, he and the Duke and the Duchess of Cambridge, they must have been properly advised by health officials. And you can be sure that after shaking people up and down, they will take necessary precautions.
Absolutely. Why not? I mean, that's the first thing.
His point about the media hyping it up, well, I guess he's expressing concern about the fact that almost on a daily basis, all the major newspapers in the UK, what they keep reporting is coronavirus, coronavirus.
So, but you know what I have to say about this? The reporting, I think, is a bit too excessive in terms of the infection itself. They're not reporting more of the people that have been cured from the virus, which I think that should be reported more and be put in front of the media. There are dozens of people that have recovered from the virus,
The media has a social responsibility.
Right.
To inform people and to educate people.
That's correct.
And in any case, if you say the reporting in the UK is excessive,
I mean, not in the UK, over the world, but even here on this channel,
we've been focusing on coronavirus almost on a daily basis on this program.
Right.
Just because we need to inform the people, we need to, educate the people and ensure that Nigerians have the right information and our viewers in other parts of the world also have the right information.
When I see videos of people that have recovered from social media, most of the comments are like, "Oh God, this is amazing. We really, really need this type of information.
We need to know
how these people recovered from this virus." And I think that that's what the media should also report hand in hand.
The unfortunate truth, and I completely agree with you, because you have to be able to have a balance in storytelling. But the unfortunate truth is that, unfortunately, COVID-19 still has pandemic potential. And for a virus that has pandemic potential, there is only one way or one strategy in which you can follow as a journalist or anyone on the front line of reporting information to ensure that you're not downplaying something with pandemic potential. So until that risk is alleviated or until that risk is lifted up off of us, I do think that the media does have a responsibility to ensure that they put the most realistic light on what is going on right now.
Like
in the UK with Boris Johnson and how, he came out yesterday talking about the fact that there could be thousands of cases. And everyone was like, "Whoa, Boris." But today everyone is waking up in the UK saying, okay, cases have trebled overnight. So thanks, Boris. So I think it is the job of the media right now to ensure that they treat this as something that does have pandemic potential, because that's what it is.
Correct. You're absolutely right on that as well. Well, let's head over to social media now. Microblogging site Twitter has come under intense criticism for testing a feature that would allow some tweets to disappear after 24 hours. The new feature called Fleets is similar to vanishing posts on Snapchat and Instagram stories. The changes has prompted the hashtag RIP Twitter to trend as users complained that the new feature will make the microblogging site too similar to other social media platforms. One user, Talkative, suggested a few options that should have been added instead of the fleet feature. He wrote, edit button, deleting wrong messages in the DM, quoting messages when replying DM. These are features that will add value to Twitter. If the story feature is added, the four main social media apps automatically becomes the same. Now, what's the joy? Hashtag RIP Twitter. Another user, Jay Wrights, wrote, it gets very tiresome for us when we post and not being able to edit what we posted. We hope this feature can be added so people can scream, long live Twitter, instead of hashtag RIP Twitter. Now, I'm not on Twitter much, Dr. Abati. I'm sure that you would...
I'm on Twitter.
You would relate to that.
I agree with the commentators who are saying that an edit button is perhaps desirable. Because you can't really edit. You have to delete and then repost. That's one. Two, about deleting messages on DM. Mm. I think Twitter already has that feature. It's called Save DM.
But for persons
who send, pornography through direct messaging, then, of course, Twitter has an app that can immediately delete it. Mm. Now, a few months ago, Twitter also came up with the idea of, tagging anything that amounts to extreme political speech or hate speech. Right. I don't know whether that has been activated yet or is still on the... in a trial phase, because I still see President Donald Trump using Twitter, to fight political battles, to abuse people, calling people a mini Joe, a small person, and all of that. And he's been doing that in the past few days. Mm-hmm. And that particular feature was supposed to check political leaders who have influence, who may be abusing that particular platform. Yeah. But as for, tweets disappearing, well, I don't know about that.
I like
Some people like to keep their tweets.
It would work for me because I'm really very shy on texting and posting, and I love the fact that my posts can disappear in 24 hours.
You know what? I would love it, but as a separate app. Like, if Twitter had a different app where you could fleet, I would love it because I still like keeping my tweets, so I don't know. It's a bit,
Yes. That's one of the reasons why they have added this, because they say that, a lot of users are very shy on Twitter, like me, and they seem like it will be permanent if they don't have the feature causes them not to have it permanent.
Absolutely.
Could we take another story?
Absolutely.
Final story?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's take our final story in Nigeria. Hundreds of protesters stormed Kano Hisba office on Wednesday over a song that is allegedly blaspheming Prophet Muhammad. Musician Yahaya Sharif Aminu is said to have composed the song that contained some alleged derogatory comments attributed to the Prophet and praises an imam to an extent it elevates him above Prophet Muhammad. The musician has since gone into hiding after the song prompted violence against his family and their home, which was invaded over the weekend by some irate youth. Idris Ibrahim, better known as Baba Idris, is the convener of the protest and has said that if the government failed to do the needful, they will take the law into their hands.
Oh, no, you won't take the law into your own hands.
That's what they're threatening.
Religion
at this point.
Is a very sensitive,
very sensitive issue
and emotive subject. But what we can say here is that it is good that the state authorities have said that they are already looking into the matter. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, this is about the freedom of expression and also the freedom of religion and worship.
Yeah.
But where religion is involved, people should be educated just to be careful.
So that you don't
offend other people's sensibilities.
Mm-hmm. Yes, but apparently this musician is from a tribe that believes, or is from a Muslim sect that believes that whatever he composed in the song is all right. And then the sect that is protesting, are very outraged about some of his lyrics.
Well, OG, thank you for what's trending today. Have a great day.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.